So I believe that at the point of lockout that I did lock the weight out, but I believe also that the weight was bumped, and that's how I lost control. I've never lost control out of at the end of a lockout at any meet that I've ever done. You know, which I'm not saying that as an excuse, but you know, I was getting ready to come back and go for a heavier weight, which would have been like 338 kilos. But Josh told me since they secured the lift and the lift was good, that there's no sense in me going out to try to do more weight, you know, because adrenaline was pumping and we didn't want to take any chances of getting any type of injury so that we could set it up for the future so I could one day go head to head with Kirill. By far, Kirill is the most technical lifter that I've ever seen in the history of bench pressing. I remember at one point before I even got to a point to where I was that high level of caliber of lifter, that I used to watch his videos and I would study and see how he did that. But still, it still blows my mind to see how easy and fluent the movement is when he bench presses. I mean, he is definitely one of the most technical benchers that I've ever seen in this town. I think by strategically attacking my programming, they were able to still continue to gain. As you can see, me and Kirill only lift heavy twice a month, pretty much. Every 9 to 12 days, we're lifting heavy. So that's a lot of, we're saving our body from all the wear and tear. But at the end of the day, the reason why I feel that I continue to progress is because of how I strategically attack my programming, how I really focus on my back, my lats, my triceps, and you know, the parts of your movement where I see that it's a weak point. I make sure that we address that weak point and we exploit that weak point to the point of making sure everything is complete. I think it all depends on your lifestyle and what you do, because your lifestyle really weighs and plays a huge role in your lifting. So at this moment, I just have time and to focus on, I got so much momentum going that I'm looking to compete again in about 3 months. And me and Kirill is gonna eventually plan something big where we can both come together and do this thing together. But for the average person, if your body can handle it, then I would say yes. Push your body to the limits, but also too, you gotta find that balance so that you won't get hurt. So I would say anywhere from 2 to 4 meets a year, making sure that you are getting the proper rest, proper hydration, and proper nutrition, because those things play a huge role in the recovery of the body. So you just have to focus on the small things. We follow up, Josh Bryant, my coach, helps me to understand and has taught me that to follow up on the small things. It's all about the small things. If you follow up on the small things, the larger things will come. So just trying to not be an ego lifter like you see on Instagram, where people are just lifting crazy weights just for exposure. I see a bigger picture in the future, so there's no point in doing that. I appreciate the love. Meal prep, baby. Ah!